As many of you may have seen, a video entitled British Shi'ism Exposed has been produced on a Shia YouTube channel most popularly known as Islamic Pulse. In the video, Muzaffar Haider extends an invitation for Sunni-Shia unity while simultaneously condemning the hostility espoused by Shirazi Twelver Shias, claiming that they do not represent what true Twelver Shia Islam is in all actuality. What is concerning, however, is the striking similarities that are embodied among both Shirazi Twelver Shias and non-Shirazi Twelver Shias. Such similarities consist of ritualized cursing and condemnation of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, and the rejection of Sunni Islam in its different aspects, in addition to sectarian hostility espoused within different Shia militias in the Middle East today. Muzaffar claims that the points of contention between Sunnis and Shias are mainly due to Shirazi Shia figures such as Yasir Habib, Imam Tawhidi, Ayatollah Sadiq al-Shirazi, and so on. He continuously insists that it is due to the behavior of only these specific Shias that sectarian violence conducted by groups like that of ISIS have been exacerbated towards Shias.
To be honest, if I was Sunni and somebody showed me a video of a Shia scholar cursing and insulting the wife of the Holy Prophet, and then told me that all Shias are like this, I'd probably want to kill Shias too, not understanding that this is only a small group of fools who are being promoted in order to create hate in the Ummah. So who are they? Mujtaba Shirazi, Yasir Habib, brother or Imam Tawhidi, and Alayari. All of these are linked in some way or the other to someone who we'll mention at the end of the video. For now, let's just call him He Who Must Not Be Named.
Is Muzaffar being impartial in his assessment, or is something more sinister taking place? Muzaffar argues that the violence between Shias and Sunnis is only a byproduct of Shirazi Shias, who often espouse sectarian rhetoric by publicly insulting revered Sunni religious figures. These are Shias that claim to be Orthodox. However, we must pose the question as to whether or not there is indeed a significant difference between normative Twelver Shi'ism and Shirazi Twelver Shias. Surely, the invocations of anti-Sunni sentiment are not simply a derivative of contemporary political rivalries, but are also extrapolated from the Shia religious tradition in and of itself as well. The irony here is that the non-Shirazi scholars, whom Muzaffar respects and promotes, are guilty of doing the same exact thing that they claim to condemn. Muzaffar regularly praises Khomeini, the predecessor of the current supreme leader of Iran, Ayatollah Ali Khamenei.
As between Shiaian, که فقط مسئلهشون مسئله نادانی نیست مأموریت دارن برای اینکه بیان به مقدسات اهل سنت اهانت کنن برای اینکه ایجاد اختلاف کنن من عرض میکنم رفتار هر دو گروه حرام شرعی است و خلاف قانونی است.
However, Khomeini holds and promotes various anti-Sunni beliefs and by extension would apply to Khamenei as well. Although during the 1979 Iranian Revolution, Khomeini openly called for Sunni-Shia unity, his books contain statements that contradicted the revolutionary slogans of unity and brotherhood. His statements, which call for unity, were very well known, yet played on the emotions of many Muslims during a time in which the heightened political climate in the Middle East was shifting as pan-Islamist movements, mainly initiated by Iran, began to manifest. During the days of the revolution, Khomeini's statements of unification were as follows. Muslims should be awake, Muslims should be alert, that if a dispute takes place among Sunni and Shiite brothers, it is harmful to us all. It is harmful to all Muslims. Those who want to sow discord are neither Sunni nor Shia. They are agents of the superpowers and work for them. Shia and Sunni brothers should avoid every kind of dispute. Today, discord among us will only benefit those who follow neither Shia nor Hanafi. They neither want this nor that to exist, and know the way to sow dispute between you and us. We must pay attention that we are all Muslims, and we all believe in the Qur'an. We all believe in Tawheed, and must work to serve the Qur'an and Tawheed. If the Muslims were a united single fist, none can rise up against them. Muslims are brothers, and will not be segregated by the Sado propaganda sponsored by corrupt elements. The source of this matter, that Shiites should be on one side, and Sunni on the other, is on the one hand ignorance, and on the other hand, propaganda of the foreigners. Ayatollah Khomeini attempts to call for Sunni-Shia unity, stating that Sunnis and Shias are brothers, and emphasizes the notion of unity by stating those who seek to sow discord belong to neither of the two sects, and goes on to invoke the Qur'an and Tawheed, as two primary unifying factors between Sunnis and Shias. On the contrary, however, we have found statements which demonstrate a contradictory viewpoint about Sunnis held by Ayatollah Khomeini. He states in Al-Makasib al-Muharrama, Volume 1, page 251, when commenting on the narration of their Imam, which states, "Backbiting, or ghiba, is when you say about your brother something that Allah has concealed." Khomeini's commentary states, "When it comes to explaining it, we took brotherhood into consideration, but the rest of the Muslims are not our brothers, even if they are called Muslims." And on the same page he says, "And one should not doubt that all of the narrations about backbiting are only talking about the believer who is loyal to the truthful Imam, alayhi salam." And on page 250, he also says, "And those narrations mentioning a brother do not include them, the Sunnis, as there is no brotherhood between us and them, after it was made obligatory to disown them and their sect and their leaders as the narrations and usul stated." Although Khomeini's slogans and quotes appeal to the emotions of Muslims, both Sunnis and Shias, across the region during the days of the 1979 revolution, ultimately, they rendered hollow and were meaningless. When one looks to his books, we find many other statements that contradict the aforementioned calls for unity. Rather, we discover his ill sentiments towards the Sahaba and Sunni Islam in the following excerpts. The following excerpt is taken from Kitab al-Tahara of Ayatollah Khomeini, Volume 3, page 457. As for the other groups of the Nawasib, in all actuality the Khawarij, they are to receive more punishment than the Kuffar, yet this does not prove them to be najis. Hence, if a sultan makes khuruj of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, not for religious reasons, rather for worldly reasons seeking power, or other motives, like Aisha, Zubayr, Talha, Muawiyah, and their likes, or if someone holds enmity or nasb towards him or of one of the 12 Imams alayhim as-salam, not due to religious reasons, rather because of his enmity towards the Quraysh or Bani Hashim or the Arabs, or because Ali killed one of his children or his father, apparently none of those are necessarily considered najis from the apparent point of view, although in fact they are more impure than dogs and pigs. As seen in the aforementioned excerpt, Khomeini attempts to conflate the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in with dogs and pigs, and thus renders them impure. In an additional excerpt from Ayatollah Khomeini's book Al-Wasiyah Al-Ilahiyya Al-Siyasiyah, on page 27 he states, "I claim with full confidence that the Iranian people and this crowd of millions in this era are better than the people of the Hijaz in the era of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, and better than the people of Kufa and Iraq during the days of Ali alayhi salam and Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, and the people of Iraq and Kufa have mistreated and wronged Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali alayhi salam, and they have disobeyed him, and he complained much about them, as recorded in the books of Hadith and history books. And the Muslims of Kufa and Iraq have done what they did to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, the master of martyrs. Those who did not commit the crime of killing him either ran away from the battle or watched until the crime was done. However, we see today that the Iranian people, with its organized armed forces, uniformity, guarding, and mobilization, and therefore the strength of the Iranian people is from volunteers on the front lines, and the masses are behind those fronts eagerly and passionately ready to make sacrifices." Additionally, Ayatollah Khomeini goes on to diminish the faith of Sunni Muslims by stating that the Iman of Sunni Muslims is invalid and incomplete due to their lack of belief in the concept of imama and or wilaya of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu and his successors. Taken from the book Kitab Amali, written by Sheikh al-Tusi, with its isnad taken from Muhammad bin Muslim al-Thaqafi, he said, "I asked Abu Ja'far bin Ali alayhi salam about the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 'For God shall change the evil of such persons into good, and God is oft forgiving, most merciful.'" From Surah al-Furqan, verse 70. So the Imam alayhi salam said, "The sinful believer shall be brought to judgment on that day. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would be the one to judge him, and none of the people shall witness his judgment. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informs him of his sins, and when he admits to his sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say to his writers, 'Change them to rewards, hasanat, and show them to the people.' Then the people will say, 'Does this slave not have one sin? then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders that he be taken into Jannah. So this is the ta'wil, meaning of that verse, and it is exclusive for our Shia. Imam Khomeini, in his commentary on the hadith, says, and it is well known that this matter is exclusive to the Shia of the Ahlul Bayt, and that it is forbidden for all those besides them. Because Iman, which does not take place except for believing in the wilaya and or imama of Ali and his pure and fallible successors, alayhim as-salam. In fact, belief in Allah and his messenger is not accepted unless it is accompanied by the belief in wilaya. Furthermore, some may say that Sunnis and Shias should unite upon the most fundamental principles of the religion without invoking the conflicts that took place after the passing of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Yet how are Sunnis able to unite with Shias, as Ayatollah Khomeini has major deficiencies even in one of the most fundamental aspects of the religion, prophethood and or messengership? If the aforementioned excerpts from Ayatollah Khomeini weren't already disturbing enough, he goes on to further undermine the da'wah efforts of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam and deem them insufficient. In Kashf al-Asrar, Ayatollah Khomeini comments on the Quranic verse in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states,
الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا.
This day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam as your religion. Ayatollah Khomeini goes on to say, and it is clear that if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam had delivered the message of imama as Allah ordered, and if he had placed some effort in this matter, many battles and conflicts would not have taken place in the Islamic world, nor would we have many differences in the usul and furu'ah of this religion. Sistani is also praised and held in high esteem by Muzaffar. Sistani has been known for promoting Sunni-Shia unity and tolerance among one another in Iraq, claiming that the two groups are not just simply brothers in faith, but that they are directly part of one another.
Ayatollah Sistani, for example, when he says, don't think of Sunnis as your brothers, they're not your brothers, they are your soul.
Yet at the same time, there seems to be contradicting statements articulated from Sistani. As ironic as it is, Sistani on the one hand claims that Sunnis and Shias are part of one another. Yet at the same time, he is also the same Shi'i cleric who called for the establishment and mobilization of the popular mobilization forces also known as Hashd al-Shi'abi, which is comprised of multiple Shia militia groups in Iraq which have participated in sectarian violence against Sunnis. Just as Muzaffar expresses remorse and regret for the sectarian rhetoric often invoked by the aforementioned scholars, so too should he also condemn Khomeini and Sistani for the same sentiments they hold.
Start spurting out disgusting things about the companions and the wives of the Holy Prophet. Now I'm sorry to have to repeat the foul things that these people say in the name of Shia Islam, but we have to reveal them for what they are, because there are still some Shias and Sunnis out there who are not aware of the chaos that these types of individuals are creating. If someone spoke this way about Imam Ali, you'd be angry, right? You'd be infuriated. You'd hate them. Maybe you'd even want to kill them. That's how people are being radicalized and made to join groups like Daesh. That's how ISIS is being created.